Respected Honorable Brothers and Elders, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in a hadith, Inna fil jasad la mudgha idha saluhat saluha al jasad kullu wa idha fasadat fasad al jasad kullu ala wa hiya al qalb. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that within every single human body there is a type of flesh. There's a bit of flesh, body, ek tukra, in every single human being's body. If that piece of flesh is okay, then the rest of your body will be okay. And if that's not okay, then the rest of your body won't be okay too. So this is what he mentioned. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِذَا فَسَدَتْ فَسَدَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ. If that piece of flesh is okay, the rest of the body will be okay, but if it's not, then the rest of the body won't be okay. And then he said three times, he stressed, he said, it's the heart, it's the heart, it's the heart. Meaning that with each and every one of us has a heart, but yet whatever corruption and things we see negative from our bodily point of view, this is because of that same heart. Any good you see is because of that heart as well. One of the issues, one of the illnesses of the heart, which we touched upon before Ramadan, and which inshallah we're going to carry on with talking about a few of these subjects, but illnesses of the heart. Because all of us have them. If we're not careful, all of us have these illnesses. You know, having pride, from an English cultural point of view, or from any culture actually, be proud of yourself, be proud of your... Yes, there's a thing of being proud of yourself to an extent, but when it doesn't involve your good, it came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ajizi should be kiasi, but this is Allah's karam, not mine. So if you are attractive, it's not going to say, yeah, I'm a good looking lad, I'm alright. Well, no, actually, Allah gave you those looks. We should make shukr ki Allah ne diye. If someone has got a lot of wealth, is it you that earned that wealth, or did Allah give you the ability to earn that wealth? If you have a certain position in society, did you give that or did Allah give you that? Because insan inherently can't do nothing. It's Allah who gives each and everything. So this is why one of the things which is the illness of the heart, and we'll jump straight to it, is the issue of pride and takabbur which insan has. In short, what is takabbur? What is pride? Takabbur basically is where arrogance or kibr is where you regard yourself better than other individuals. It's an inner thing. And takabbur is demonstrated externally when you interact with people. So for example, a person may think that they're better than other people because of some money which they've got. That's kibr. And when they talk to people, they talk condescendingly. They talk to them low. They talk to them in a way which is demeaning, which is not right, which is not decent, which is not correct. This we would refer to as takabbur. Now, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Numan ibn Bashir radiallahu anhu, he mentions a beautiful hadith. And some of you may think, well, what's wrong with it? Because the reality is, the wider world, they may say, what's wrong with being proud? What's wrong with having pride? Is there something wrong? Well, from an Islamic point of view, it is. Because this is tantamount of the shaitan, the traps of shaitan. What did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say? Nu'man ibn Bashir is the narrator of the hadith. He mentioned, inna li shaitan masaliya wa fakhukha. Shaitan has some snares, some traps, some ways to rip you off and take you off of your iman. And وَإِنَّ مَصَالِيَ الشَّيْطَانِ وَفَخُوخَهُ الْبَطَرُ بِأَنْعُمِ اللَّهِ. Number one, he makes you have pride over the ni'mas and the blessings which Allah gave you. Number one, وَالْفَخُرُ بِعَطَاءِ اللَّهِ. And then you become boastful of the things which Allah has given you. So you have pride of Allah's ni'mas, and then what you have been given, you then act with arrogance. Number three, وَالْكِبْرِيَاءُ عَلَىٰ عِبَادِ اللَّهِ. And then you have a sense of exaltedness, a sense of haughtiness, a sense of pride over people. We look down upon people. This is number three. And number four, another trap of shaitan. So number one was what? الْفَخْرُ الْبَطْرُ بِأَنْعُمِ اللَّهِ. So basically pride with the ni'mas of Allah. Number two was arrogance, fakhr, boastfulness when it comes to the givings and the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number three, pride, exaltedness, better than thou attitude when it comes to dealing with people. And number four, وَإِتِّبَاعُ الْهَوَىٰ فِي غَيْرِ ذَاتِ اللَّهِ. Where a person follows his desires in everything beside what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants. These, in short, why you and I, we have to rid ourselves from this thing, because it's tantamount to that which shaitan has. Is that thing which shaitan wants to ensnare us with, trap us with, take us away from our iman with. This is why it's dangerous. What is that thing that shaitan had which made him mardood in the court of Allah? It was that very same thing of pride. Because what he thought was, hold on a second, Ya Allah, you've created me from fire, but you created him from mud. What caused him to disobey Allah? He became mardood because he rejected Allah's hukum. How can he? Why did shaitan become mardood? Because Allah ne kaha sajda karo, he didn't do sajda. But what caused him not to want to make sajda? What was that sifat and that quality? Unhelpful, bad quality. Pride. Because he thought, who's he? Well, having this attitude can really cause harm for an individual throughout their life in a number of ways. Because a person becomes arrogant to the truth, a person becomes closed to anything of khair, a person starts thinking that they're better than other individuals, and all these things are tantamount to illness and harm and issues which will create for a person in their spirituality and their dindari. That's why we have to constantly check ourselves again and again and make sure that we don't become a victim of this way of thinking. Some of the things, for example, right? Some of the causes of takabbur, basically education is one of them. A person who has a certain type of education, he may look at others as jahil. Jahil pendu log yaar, what do they know? Pendu log yaar sare. Asan taleem yafta log, we educated people yet. That mentality. And unfortunately, when you got two types of knowledge, ilm al-nafi', beneficial knowledge, and ilm which is not beneficial. That knowledge which shows you who your Allah is, who shows you who Rasulullah is, proper knowledge, where you should never become proud over people, you should never have arrogance over people, because the whole basis of the education is to bring humility within oneself. Okay? But another cause for the takabbur is that religious service. I've noticed this as well, and may Allah forgive me for being so straightforward and blunt, right? But it's a very big issue amongst our communities that people who have certain positions within our society, if it's a masjid chairman, a masjid secretary, a khazanji, a treasurer, mashallah, slowly they start off with this, you know, we want to serve the people and we want to do good. And before we know it, mashallah, Hazrat's demanding a first place behind the saf of the imam because now I'm the guy who's running the place. So with religious service comes takabbur, and I will not be shy to say, unfortunately, this is ulama have this as well. Maulviyon ke andar bahut hai bhai. Don't be fooled, because one maulvi ko hazam nahi hota ke aglo, why has he got this much respect? Why haven't I got that respect? This is a and then we start saying, nay, you know, this maulvi, this is wabi maulvi, this is this maulvi, this, because we can't stand to tolerate someone's halqa getting bigger and bigger, so we start causing these fitna and fasads. If you look at the jar, why they're doing that, often it's hasad, envy, jealousy, takabbur, all these things. You see, so that's why, how it affects religious, no different as well. Another thing, subhanAllah, ancestry. These are all things. Someone thinks, well, I'm, you know who I am, brother. My family, mashallah, we're Khan family, we're Chaudhrys, mashallah. We're from this family, we're from this side of town, we're this type of people. We can't marry into your low caste of people. Who decided which caste is better than what? Who decided this? We were once a nation of people, and some colonialists come and divided up our countries and said, right, that's for this country, that's for that country, that's going to be your flag, that's going to be your flag, that's going to be your way of life, that's going to be your currency. And we fell into the trap. Muslims never thought like this. Muslims never thought along the lines of Indian and Bengali and Sri Lankan and Karachi and Sylhet and Algeria, Morocco. This was non-existent in the Ummah. Non-existent. But when this kicks in, qasam by Allah, this can make takabbur as well, because we think we're better than other people. So this is another issue which can cause. Another issue on top of that as well is beauty. Someone's attractive, someone's good looking, they may feel better than other people. Now, how the hal, solution, if a person feeling that they've got takabbur through their education, when they should always constantly think to themselves, okay, how did I acquire this knowledge? Who gave me my brain? Rozana, every day a person should sit down and think to themselves, if they're a victim of this, because it starts small, and then it starts taking over a person's life, and then it gets to a stage where a person, what are the ultimate harms? Because a person locks off to the truth. Because of the takabbur, you don't listen to anything. People say, no, I'm not listening to that. They close off from anything of haqq. And that's what happens, everything falls on deaf ears. Even qala Allah, qala Rasul, even what Allah said, and what the Prophet ﷺ said. People say, no, I'm not accepting that. It doesn't make sense. It sounds backwards to me. This all comes from takabbur, because if I think that I'm not knowledgeable, how am I supposed to understand? If you have that humble mentality that anything which gets put forward, you take it and say, inshallah, I will try my best. But if we think we're more better than that, we're more knowledgeable, we act with arrogance, you can see where this is ending up, where a person locks off to the truth. Again, when it comes to, for example, religious service, a person should think to themselves and remind themselves of a hadith where there'll be three people called on the Day of Judgment and they'll be all thrown in the fire of Jahannam because they didn't have a correct intention. One of them is a Maulvi as well, bichara. who learned knowledge and he thought, mashallah, bade bade murid ho rahe, and he's got a big halqa of people, he's also going to the fire of Jahannam. A mujahid, someone who strove in the path of Allah and died, even he'll go to the fire of Jahannam. And number three, that individual that gave lots of money to charity, but he did it because someone wanted him to, he wanted to be called, mashallah, generous. Hazrat, mashallah, dekho kitne. Alhamdulillah, look how generous Khan sahib is, mashallah. Look how generous Chaudhary sahib is, mashallah. Dekho, Miyan sahib ko dekho kitne kharaj karte, mashallah. So we're doing it with the wrong intention. These three people, Allah will throw into Jahannam first on the Day of Judgment. Soche zara yaar. Bazaar, they look like good deeds. So whenever we're doing a religious service, we shouldn't think, feel proud of it. We should say, Ya Allah, Allah ka shukr, you gave me the tawfiq to serve the people. I'm doing that job which the Anbiya alayhi wasalam did. It's a different way of thinking. When it comes to beauty, again, this is all the gifts of Allah. Again, I go back to my opening statement. I said we should always turn everything back to Allah. Whatever I have, anything I have, my looks, my wealth, my health, my education, all is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And again, from hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned one very hadith Qudsi, where Allah said, Al-kibriya'u rida'i wal-azmatu izari. Kibriya and pride and greatness belongs to me. It's my upper and lower garment. And if anyone tries to snatch that from me, Allah is saying this, فَمَنْ نَازَعَيْنِي وَاحِدًا مِنْهُمَا قَضَفْتُهُ فِي النَّارِ. If anyone tries to take one of these garments from me, my garments that belong to me, I am great, I am exalted. If anyone tries to take that from me, I'm going to personally throw him in the fire of Jahannam. And these are stern words. And don't think it's hadith, maybe weak, kamzor, sahih hadith. I never will mention just some jahili cocoa pop back on box hadith. All proper, mashallah, hadith. Tirmizi Sharif, Mishkat Sharif, if you want to do the takhrij, you can by all means have a look. So as a Muslim, short reminder, short nasiha is what? We need to analyze our lives, and we need to see our lives. Have I got those qualities that are unhelpful that will hurt me in the akhirah? But they will also hurt me in this dunya as well. Because when a person has takabur, Allah Ta'ala reduces and debases that person. But when a person is humble, people love humble people. Unfortunately, our culture doesn't admit that, though. It doesn't allow it. I mean, I had a relative, right, subhanAllah, who's in the army, and his son came home, and he was doing some pushti with a friend. Like, oh, youngsters, they fight. And it was just a play fight. And you know this pocket, it was ripped a little bit. So he said to him, you can't come back in my house. You'll come as a bagharat. You have to go and usnik sari give it park to firai. You have to rip his qameez because you have to show that we're, mashallah, Malik brotherly and we're colonels, putra, and so on. And look at the bamboo man. That's jahil. That's what you know, it happened as two people, as two friends, they were just doing a bit of fighting. Oh, mashallah, just ripped a little bit. But the old man to kick him out of the house and say, you have to rip his qameez, otherwise you're so bagharat, you can't come in my house. We are plugging the taqabbur into our children by telling them, you know, you're better than this. Don't ever do this. You know who you are. You know how much money you got. I was the one who used to scrub dishes for £2 an hour. You, mashallah. See, we're sowing the seeds of the taqabbur. That sows arrogance. It's like, you know who I am. Why should I listen to you? Bro, we used to clean dishes. We were educated people. It backfires. See, backfires big time. So, khair, let's leave that here. In short, in summary, in quick. Taqabbur, pride, arrogance. These are ills of the heart. Analyze, remove. Every day, sit down for a few minutes, analyze what we have, which angle that the taqabbur is coming from, whether it's wealth, pride, whether it's wealth, beauty, money, education, whatever it is, and always think, Ya Allah, it's your karam, you gave me beauty. It's your karam, Ya Allah, you gave me that wealth. Oh Allah, it's your karam and your blessing, you gave me that education. And always put everything back to Allah. Then Allah Ta'ala will open and give us even more because we'll be worthy of more, inshallah. Allah give us tawfiq. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi.